Hello, space cadets. As you can see, I made it to Mars, which was only 100 kilometers away. I found that pretty funny. I thought I would need, like, jump drives, take me days. It took about 30 minutes, flying from the alien planet to Mars. I realized, just from the perspective, that the alien planet is much, much larger than Mars. Mars looked like it was about the size of Earth's moon in comparison. And maybe that's what this is modeled after, I'm not sure. My landing was excellent. From space, I was able to see where the mountains were, where the desert flats were, and where the ice lakes were. So I just plotted a course to land right in between the mountains and the lakes. So I hit that smack dab. I'm on an ice lake right now. I just decided to get some iron out of this hole, and I figured I'd share the view. So we put the HUD back on and get this bad boy hooked up, and we'll go back to the other ship, which I'll show you here in a moment. But I've been doing a lot of building, and I used up a lot of iron, and I don't really know how long I'm going to stay on Mars. I'll probably drive around just to check it out. That's unloading. See, you got a pretty nice view here. So I can't climb that with the truck. So I'm kind of stuck where I'm at. I don't know if there's a, if I drive far enough down, maybe I can find a ramp up. But what's interesting here is it says there's no oxygen, but there's obviously an atmosphere because I can fly my minor ship around, which only has atmospheric engines. Maybe this is like a carbon dioxide atmosphere or something, but the gravity is very low, which has been great for mining and building. So near the mountain I was talking about. And I think way, way down there is Earth, where crosshairs are. The funny thing is I didn't run across a single asteroid while I was in space, and that kind of bothers me because I was hoping to run into some and get platinum. As you know, if you play this game at all, there's no platinum on the planet. You have to get it in space off of asteroids. That's another nice thing. The jetpack is kind of optional. You're not going to fall to your death on life on the alien world. I just want to make sure that the now I hate when they make that noise. That means they're taking bites out of my rig. Can't have that. I see him under there. Yeah, this is like my favorite weapon in the game. I don't even know what it's called. I know it's a modded weapon. Compact automatic rifle. Viper. It's great against the spiders. And my sonar ping's going off, I think because it's detecting the other ship. I haven't seen any pirates, any pirate bases, pretty much nothing. Except for those dang spiders. Okay, I did manage to grab some ice, which I don't want to put in this. I can barely carry any of it. Alright, so I'll transfer it down to this storage. Be like my backup ice. So I got my cockpit generator full. You know what I could do? Is just put it in the other, and put it in my, do this. I think it unloaded all the ore automatically. It just didn't take the ice. Yeah, it did. Okay, so the ore is being processed. You see, I did a little bit of a redesign. I'll explain that in a moment. careful I don't smack things too hard, even though I have everything made out of heavy armor. Damage is still possible. Well, that was interesting. Just slammed me down. Okay. Yeah, now that should take the ice. I already have this maxed out. What it's processing ice for? Oh, maybe because I'm hooked up. Wow, it looks like I have the onboard hydrogen system just completely maxed out, so I'm gonna probably have to move this ice to the other ship. So I'm just gonna leave that, leave the miner outside. Hooked up to that. Let's trek back to the other vehicle. I'll show you that. Let me zoom in here real quick. Maybe you can see it from here. See, I built this all up. This has a merge block on it now, connected to a conveyor, which is then, connected to the connector. So this vehicle keeps getting taller and taller. It's pretty hilarious. But I think I'm going to wind up moving these guns because now they can't fire forward. I'm probably going to move them to the back here if I can find a way to do that without blocking the port. I haven't taken all the engines off the bottom yet. I will do that soon. I just was busy with my other craft. I'm going to show you that. But it's pretty awesome that I have hooked up. But I don't have the pistons down. This thing gets heavier and heavier, and it becomes more and more impossible to actually drive it like a vehicle. I also turned down my FRAPS resolution from full to half. Hopefully the video won't come out looking like crap. But it's literally taking 1 gig for every 15 seconds of recording. So, I'm basically chewing up my entire hard drive just to record a 10-minute video. Here's what I did with the booster. I turned it into a ship because it seemed like the easiest way to move it around. I put a landing gear on it just for stability reasons because it would actually rest on these big rockets. But there's the merge block and then there's the connector. So I could actually merge block it to the truck and use it as a booster, or I can hook up connector to connector and transfer ice because this is fully hydrogen powered. It uses no electricity to maneuver. These are all hydrogen engines, so it uses the onboard hydrogen. These guys are always interrupting me, Yeah, lots of plate. I can't carry anymore. So I can hook up either way. which is cool. And I can use this landing gear to bolt onto the back of things. I was actually thinking about putting one on front. I can actually use this, or put two landing gear on front and use it as basically a lifting machine, so you can use the landing gear to grasp onto like a big space station or something and move it. Because this is a very powerful machine. I put a single solar panel on it, and there's a script that I downloaded from the workshop that keeps the solar panel pointed at the sun, mostly. Seems like it's working okay now. It was kind of funky earlier. They did say the development build broke it. I did a workaround by putting the sun sensor at a 90 degree angle. It's supposed to be on the panel itself, but that wasn't working, so I just worked with it. It seems to be doing okay. It keeps the battery topped off, because this has no reactors on it. This only has a battery to power it. The reactors are just too big, and I figured, since this is hydrogen powered anyway, as long as I keep all the electrics off, you can see the gyroscope and everything's off right now. If I keep the electrics off and I have it parked where there's some sun, it'll keep the battery topped off. So when it, you know, if it gets too low, I just plug into the truck will recharge it. Otherwise, the solar panel will keep the battery topped off. I did put an antenna on it. Unfortunately, I don't make smaller antennas. This was just so that I could remote control it if I need to, and also so I won't lose it if I drive too far away. I put an LCD panel on it, of course. It gives me the status of the hydrogen tanks and the batteries and stuff. So it's all pretty standard, but it's cool because it's the first big ship I've built. I've done some space station stuff, but I never built any large ships. So this is a start. Basically, its utilitarian purpose is to be a lifter. You know, it can plug in with the merge block to the truck and move it into space. And that's exactly what I'm doing. I put a bunch of ice in it. I made three trips to that lake. And you can see it's still... I'm only a third full with ice because this holds a lot of ice, 550K. So I'm only about a third of the way there. I don't really know if I'm going to make any more trips. That should be plenty of ice to get wherever I need to go. So that's that. I got my iron, which is going to be processed. I think I'm going to move these guns before I lift off, but I think I'm probably just going to... I don't know if I'm going to drive around Mars anymore. I don't think there's anything here. So, I really want to find some asteroids in space to mine. And that's going to, of course, require a redesign of the miner ship, because this has all atmospheric engines. Now, am I going to rip every engine off and change it to ion? I don't think so. I don't know what I'm going to do. I really should just design a separate ship. You know, I'd like to have this hydrogen power, but the tanks are just too large. I mean, the tank alone is, I think, like... How big is it? It's like massive. It's like 4x4, 5x5. So I'd have to strap one of these onto it. That'd be like, that just wouldn't work. Why am I moving to the side? It's so weird. It's like there's gravity here, but there's not. Okay. Oh, because the truck's moving backwards. I still gotta use the pistons. Which, you know, they continuously break. Pistons in the game, see? One of them didn't come down. Pistons in the game are broken just like the rotors, so you have to be patient and work around all the bugs. Like, you know, you just saw. Didn't come down. Which means, for no reason whatsoever, one of them lost a head. They just disappear. I just don't understand it. It's not like I put them down when I'm moving or, you know, trying to park on them out or anything like that. They're just very, very delicate. They should make them so they're a little stronger. Whatever. There's so many bugs in this game that sometimes I sit there and go, is it worth playing? But, you know, if you work around them, it's not too bad. I think I figured out how to get around the rotor issue. it's very, very sensitive to do. But see, right now we're okay. It's sitting at the, right in the center like it should be. But that thing screws up constantly, which throws off the whole balance of the truck. Makes it so I can't even drive it. But it's been behaving so far, and the last few times I was able to correct it, so no big deal. So I think what I'm going to do, I might just take off. I might just say, screw Mars, take off, see if I can find some asteroids, and maybe I can attach a jump drive to this thing, and a whole ton, buttload of batteries, and then I know the jump drive takes a lot of power, and then maybe jump to Earth. See if I can find some space pirates or something, because it's been a little too quiet. I have these scripts installed. Maybe they're all broken by a development build. I don't know. But, I need some action. So, until next time. I wanted you to check this out. They say in the game that you will not find platinum on planets. I am on Mars, and I just found platinum. It is about 60 meters below the surface, but it is there, and I'm going to get it. I was actually in a search for gold, so I could make a warp drive, but I have not been able to find any gold whatsoever, but amazingly enough, platinum, so I'm gonna snag it while I'm here. I just wanted to share how much fun this is to drive across a low gravity environment in this eight-wheeled truck. I mean, I'm getting some serious air. Do you like my wheels leave the ground in those situations? As long as I'm careful. Now we got some ice down here. Oh, better slow down for this. I'll get some serious air. Oh, yeah. This is not good. Stop. I think I made it out of that without wrecking anything. Nope, no, I lost my guns. Dang it. Ah. Alright, I'm gonna show you guys how to fix the rotor problem. Or at least, how I should be able to fix the rotor problem. You see how my screen's all screwed up, like I'm off to the side of the cockpit? That means that the rotor's out of alignment again. This happens all the time. See, it's supposed to be visible at 180 degrees. It's actually high and pushed forward. So what I do is I used to do it from the cockpit of the small grid, but I realized I have to do it from the large grid. So this is connected to the large grid with the refinery and everything. So you bring up your rotor. This one's called rotor main. This is the main rotor between the small grid and the big grid. Now here's my settings. I have torque and braking set to zero. Velocity set to just something small. Lower and upper limit is plus and minus 1 degree from zero, which is, it should be at zero, but I found out if you have it at zero, this doesn't work. So, and I have my safety lock at a very low number, so it doesn't shock the system and explode anything. There's no guarantees. I mean, 25% of the time your vehicle's going to explode. So the only way you get around that is to leave the game, turn damage off, come back in and do this. I have damage on, so we'll see if anything explodes or not. So I shut the safety lock override off. This should fix the rotor. Okay, you see how it disappeared off the screen. Go back to the rotor, re-click your safety override. So now it's locked. It should be back in. This is a workaround that I found for a serious bug in the game. See, there's the rotor, it's now visible, it's now at 180 degrees. Everything should be golden and wonderful. The cockpit is back to normal. So, with that note, let's continue on our journey. I'm flying back to the lifter ship because I think I'm done with Mars. I spent a couple of hours here getting some gold and some platinum. Trying not to flip this thing. I've been finding a lot of uranium deposits. They were saying how like rare everything uranium is, but I don't know. It seems like every other friggin' thing I find it. Samaritan. So the bad thing about going external view is that you don't realize just how fast you're going. I have all these thrusters on to try to keep upright in this low gravity and try to keep the vehicle straight when I do move the ground. Of course it doesn't always work. It certainly is a lot of fun driving this though. You know, in hindsight, if I knew I was going to be this much trouble with a big ship, little ship, I would have just done a big ship. I would have just made a large vehicle instead of making a small vehicle. I just didn't want these super giant wheels, but you know, in hindsight, I kind of would have liked larger wheels with more suspension, so I'd have better ground clearance. Ground clearance on this thing kind of sucks. I mean, a spider can't even get underneath it. Here we go with the lag spikes again. There's the drop ship out there in the distance. I'm going to go ahead and cut it here. And I think I'm going to hook this baby up and get back into space. Here, I thought you might want to see the process of connecting with the merge blocks. If I can get the right angle. And just like that, it becomes one ship. Now, the problem is that once you do that, since I have the rotor issue, I now need to go realign the rotor again, because every time it seems like it blows the rotor out. Which you can see. Oh, it looks like it zeroed out. I heard it smack and bang, and I thought that, because last time I did it, it cut the power off. Well, that's not cool, it just dumped a bunch of stuff on the ground. There. I forgot to shut those off. It was just smoking through the hydrogen reserves. Where's the refinery? Did it blow up the refinery? That's why I see stuff all over the ground. I'm gonna have to guess yes. Yeah, well, let's see. There's nothing like having to restore from the game constantly because of the crappy friggin' bug on this thing. Yeah, it has to be the case because that's all the stuff that I had in the refinery. Assembler. Refinery doesn't even exist. Oh yeah, refinery's gone. Check this out. That's my platinum. Yeah. Merging blew out the refinery. This is the kind of bugs that you have to deal with in the game. Alright, restored from save game. And we're back again after two attempts. I finally shut damage off because it just kept exploding everything. It looks like even with damage turned off, it is still screwing up the rotor. I shut off override just to see if that would be an issue or not. Let me see. It's like you're in the cockpit. It looks pretty standard. So I think with the damage turned off, nothing exploded, of course. That rotor is not sitting right. Still, there should be a shaft there that you can see. I'll try locking it again and see if it straightens itself out. This is the biggest bug in the game. I mean, I can't tell you how many times I had to restore a save and do something 3 or 4 times. Okay, I put the override in. It should definitely have straightened it out. Better. But I guess if it's working, I'll just leave it. I wonder if I should leave the lock on or off. I'm just going to leave damage off until I unhook, because I don't really expect to run into any bad guys or anything. It's literally 3 minutes below the game, so every time I go out, switch a setting, come back, you know, it's another 3 minutes. And I literally spent the last half an hour just trying to open this thing up. So. Seem like there's anything funky going on. I'll just leave it. Usually makes a loud bang sound when the rotor moves. So, okay. And of course, I wasn't paying attention, so I left the friggin' engines on. See how much hydrogen did I blow. Enough. I had the ice up above a third. Now it's down to about a third, just from that little maneuver. So, I think it's time to get the hell out of here. There's really nothing left on Mars for me. I'm gonna try to make a run for Earth. And between here and there, I hope to find some asteroids so that I can get more gold. Because I need more gold to make the superconducting coils that I need for the warp drive. I think getting to Earth manually, it's just going to take way too long. I know it's like really, really far away. So, I'm hoping just to find some asteroids between here and there and mine those. So, looking forward to getting this thing. Low gravity or zero gravity environment again. Alright. I think... Yeah, I think I can just take it from here, because... Okay, so 5 is going to be pointless. Really, I just need the ion thruster on this turned on. I'll worry about the radar once I get into orbit. Leave the brake on. Oh! All my shortcuts are gone. That is. I am connected to that craft via merge block. I should be able to access its inventory. It says no hydrogen block detected. Merge blocks. Power's on, right? It do have the power on. Brake lock. Yeah, all my power's on. What's going on? It's supposed to act like one ship. I'm gonna have to dig into this before I take off. I found yet another flippin' bug in the game. Whenever you use merge blocks, they're supposed to attach the two grids together and act as one. It's just like having one big ship instead of two smaller ships. It doesn't work through the rotor. That's why these hotkeys I have don't don't work anymore. And it says over on the left, over here, that no hydrogen tanks found. Because it's supposed to, when these ships merge, it's supposed to see those tanks. Now, it's seeing the large ship inside that has the assembler, refinery, and so on and so forth. So, my truck, small grid, can see the big grid inside with the refinery. The big grid inside can see the booster ship, but they can't see each other, so there's no electricity passing through. Like, the whole point of this was to use the merge block to allow it to pass commands and electricity through, but apparently it doesn't pass through the rotor, because it has to go through the merge blocks and through the rotor. That doesn't work. So if I want to recharge the battery, what I'm going to need to do is use the connectors and hook these two guys up and then let it charge. But the battery's full right now, or it doesn't need to be charged. I'm just saying, in case it does run down. It's at 98%. Almost 5 hours of power at idle, so no problem. It's going to take very little to lift off with the low gravity here, so I should be able to easily do this. Now, since these ships aren't talking to each other, I'm going to have to make sure that I shut everything off. So, no engines at all. Because otherwise, the truck is going to fight against the booster ship. This way, it's just... And I'm going to leave the pistons up. When I land at the next place, I'm just going to be very careful. I really don't want to try to land with the pistons down. I think the suspension on the truck is better. So what I'll have to do, instead of flying the truck, which is what I originally wanted to do, I'm going to have to fly this. So. Which isn't, it's not a huge deal, but I was really hoping it would be able to transfer commands and power. But since it doesn't, that kind of sucks. Okay, so, I forgot, since I restored. I realized I can get it to... use the names of the ships instead of STF, it's the rotor, whatever. I need to shut that off too. And I'll do the, I did the minor ship before. I'll just have to, I'll have to go through and set that later. It's not really a big deal. I just want to take off. Okay, so. Batteries are on. Basically, thrusters. I probably don't need the mains. Let's see. Yeah, I think I should probably. Finding the weight of the truck is an imbalance since it's not acting as one giant ship like it should be. So I'm going to have to fight this the whole way. This is not what I wanted. Let's give her a little more. Yeah, this is going to be tough. I'm fighting the controls and they're not very fast. chugging out on me so that I can disconnect stuff. Yeah, it's just completely locked up. There we go. That's so weird. It's like one day it has a cap, the other it doesn't. What's it shooting at? Well, that's a real pain. I couldn't imagine trying to do that on a planet that has a lot of gravity. I'm screwed up. Anyway, I'm out in space. I'll aim towards Earth. Maybe I should shut off my hydrogen. Yeah, that's really funky. And it doesn't see it's not seeing the small ship at all. It's not seeing the weight of the truck. It's calculation, therefore it's like I'm using landing gear to pick it up instead of merge block, which that's the whole friggin' reason for merge blocks. Alright, well, onwards and upwards. I wonder what that is. I never saw that. I wonder if that's, planet. I don't know what planet that would be. Check it out. We're going some serious Star Trek speeds here. So fast that the rotor and the solar panel is freaking out. It's not designed to go this fast. I'm going about 350 kilometers an hour. By space standards is slow. I'm thinking now that is not Mars, but actually a moon of this green planet, because I think straight ahead is Mars. So that's the direction we're heading, and I have my radar on in hopes of finding some asteroids to mine on the way. And yeah, it's actually picking up the asteroids on the planet's surface. That's how good the radar is. I have it set to 50 kilometers, so if anything gets close, I should be able to pick it up. Still can't get over the merge block bug that defeats the whole purpose of what I'm doing with this ship, right? It's like, there's no way in a heavy gravity environment I'm going to be able to control it. It worked fine whenever I had the ship manually connected, but I don't think there's any way to do that now. They're like separate ships, and trying to get them to merge without a merge block, I don't think there's a way to do it. Unless I do the merge block first and then build other blocks to make it permanent, but I don't have any room for that. I'd have to destroy that. I guess I could do it. If I really wanted to do it, I could tear out that connector and put a temporary steel block there, and then bust the merge blocks, and then it would act like before, where everything was like one ship. But apparently the bug, that's just another bug. So it looks like we're going to cruise until I find something interesting to stop, otherwise I'm going to smack into Mars eventually. I don't have enough gold, at least I don't think I have enough gold to build a warp drive. I'm gonna check on progress. In fact, I'll do that right now. Oh, yeah, it doesn't see the other ship as part of my, it doesn't see the internals as part of my ship anymore. I wonder if it's even getting any power. Oh, that's interesting. Man, this thing's all screwed up. I mean, I could go outside and manually try to do this, but... Oh boy. Crash. Check it out, peoples. I just scored myself a fighter craft. It was floating around out here by this asteroid. My radar picked it up, and I went, and it was out of fuel. So I had to cut into it a few places to find where the reactor was and fill it up. And it's a pretty maneuverable sucker. I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to convert this to a, basically a space miner. Because I don't want to rip apart my other one that fits in the bay. I can just park this guy on the back, for the most part. And if I can find some way to conveyor all the way into the back, that's going to be the hard part, is the storage is in the back with the connector. And if I put a drill up front, I'd have to run conduit, basically connectors, to send the stuff to the back. Because I really don't need a fighter, at least I haven't seen any bad guys yet. But yeah, it's pretty cool. Save me some time. Or at least, you know, if that doesn't work out, I can grind it down. But I kind of like the design. You know, it's already got antenna and all the ion thrusters, like six in every direction, I think. And then I just tear the guns off the front and put a drill on it. There we go. So I think that's probably what I'll do, because there's a lot of asteroids around here. This whole area is just filled with them. I mean, you can see them everywhere. Everywhere you look, there's just a ton of them. And none of them had gold that I've been to yet, but flying this big beast around to each one is really a pain, because this thing's big and takes a lot of fuel. It'd be a lot easier just to take an ion thruster like this, put an ore detector on it, and fly around and see if I can find something good, and fill it up. Since it's already got a connector port at the bottom, so I can just shoop right over there. Of course, I have to move this guy out of the way. Boy, that handles like crap. I tell you what, I was just really thinking about just bust this connector out right here. Just put a steel block to join the two ships, then bust this out and be done with it, because it's so problematic. This whole thing just shakes around. And look, the power's not transferring, so it's already down to half the battery. When it runs out, I have no way to charge it. I mean, I just got one solar panel, so... And that doesn't even get to point toward the sun properly, but then again, it's not really. The ship isn't rotated in that direction, so it's probably doing the best it can. Anyway, I wanted to show you my score, and I'm going to get back to see if I can find some gold. I'm short probably 60 or 70 tons in order to make a jump drive. Getting to the next planet is taking a long time. I'm glad I found this asteroid belt. And I'm going to go spend a little time here and look around. Maybe I can score another ship or two. That'd be cool. Until then, check out this mega score. I was out prowling the asteroid belt, and I saw this enemy. And he just popped out of nowhere, and I realized he wasn't really getting that much closer to me. And so I took this ship, which does have some weapons on it. I got closer, I started firing, and I realized the thing was just, like, flipping circles, like, mad. Like, I guess something was wrong with the programming, and it was just basically spinning around like a pulsar. So I used the ship. I got close enough to it, put the gear on auto lock, and was able to snag it and use my thrusters to stop it. And it did have two of these turrets on it, but I managed with my grinder to sneak behind these jets, you know, where it can't get me. I was like, "Gee!" So I ground them down, shut them off. I got inside, and where did I get in on this side? Yeah, I got in on this side. It's got a nice reactor in here. Look at my score. 55 uranium. That is a lot of uranium for a ship. So, yeah, I started shooting the sensors, you know, because I figured there was a self-destruct. A lot of these ships have a self-destruct. But I'm going to take this baby back to the main ship and grind it down for parts, because there's a lot of good stuff here. I mean, I can't really use it myself because there's really no passenger area in it. It's basically, it was just a guided gunship. So I'm going to take this sucker back. Hopefully another one won't appear anytime soon. And, cool, at least I still haven't found any gold out here, but at least I got some goodies, right? So now I just gotta find out where my ship is. No, I better fix that. I see a piece floating around. What's gonna happen is my radar is gonna detect it as a ship. So maybe I'll grind it down. Okay. This happened before. I didn't realize it. I left a gyro floating in space, and it's detected as a small ship, and I was chasing it down, not realizing it was just the gyro. I thought I was getting, like, another score, right? Oh, well. So I'm going to head back to the ship, grind this down, keep searching my asteroid belt here and see if I can find some gold. Got to get that gold in order for me to make a jump drive.